Today we are going to compare our Liberty engine with two commercial power stations with lithium batteries and solar charging. Who do you think will win? Join us and watch it. Let's meet the competitors first. Liberty engine is a self-powered motor that we have created from an alternator. It uses neodymium magnets to generate unlimited energy. This engine is capable of generating power up to 10,000 watts without any fuel. If you don't know it, you can see the manufacturing process and the tests we did in a series of videos that you can find in the description or up here. Let's go with the first engine. The Pecron E2000 LFP with live PO4 lithium iron phosphate batteries that can retain up to 80% of their capacity after 3500 cycles. This battery has an external power supply. The battery comes nicely packaged with boxes for the different components. Here you can see the cables to connect the solar panel. This is the dust cover. And here we have the power station, created with a flame retardant ABS plastic material. It incorporates 16 output ports that can be connected all at once. These two buttons activate DC and AC power. Four outputs of 220 volts and 2000 watts total power and pure sine wave. Three USB ports and other outputs. It can be recharged with a solar panel or other inputs, and allows fast charging in about 2 hours without compromising battery capacity. As you can see, the charger disconnects at 100% charge. The top part is a handy wireless mobile charger, which works very well. Additional batteries can be connected to expand capacity up to 8 kW of power. It also allows you to transfer the charge flow through the main battery and the expansions. The total capacity of this battery is 1920 watts. The display allows us to know the consumption and battery life with the current consumption at all times. It also incorporates a car charger output. Will it be a worthy rival for the Liberty engine? Let's take a look at its solar panel. The Pecron Aurora 200, a panel of 200 watts and 36 volts. It comes wrapped in a practical suitcase format, which makes it very easily transportable. It unfolds into four large sheets that incorporate legs that can be opened to place the panel in an almost vertical position. The cables are hidden in a well-protected packet. Let's try to connect the panel. Even if we are not in the sun, our bulbs will already generate a small charge. As advertised, it converts up to 21% more solar energy than other commercial panels. It will be a good contender. Let's go now to the Delta 2 from Ecoflow. This power station incorporates Xtreme, a proprietary technology that allows 80% of the battery to be recharged in just 1 hour. Fully charging it will take 2 hours. This battery is more portable and smaller than the Pecron battery, but also has slightly less capacity and power. Here we can see the components also come nicely packaged. It includes cables for the various charging sockets and other stuff. It also has a pure sine wave converter of 220 volts and 1800 watts of power. In addition, it has the possibility of connecting other units to increase the power. It incorporates 13 sockets with which 13 devices can be powered simultaneously. The Ecoflow is a very compact unit with a sober design, although it looks less resistant than the Pecron, but it is more portable and lighter. It features X-Boost technology, which allows overloads of 2400 watts without danger. Fast charging states that in 55 minutes it will charge to 100%. The Ecoflow comes with a free app with which you can connect and check the charge, customize settings, and adjust the charging speed. The estimated battery life is 3,000 cycles or 10 years. Here we can see the number of operating hours goes down as you power the grinder. Let's see what the solar panel looks like. This panel has no legs and is prepared to be placed horizontally, so it has some anchors to fix it, for example on top of a caravan. This panel comes protected in a suitcase-shaped case for easy transport and better protection. The cables are less protected, but as they are inside the case, they are not at risk. This panel consists of four folded panels with a capacity of 220 watts and a full charge in just 3 to 6 hours. It uses a technology called MMPT to maximize charging efficiency. The construction material is awesome. It's really tough and you can tell it will hold up perfectly in any climate conditions. Here you can see how the anchors work to attach the panel. Solar charging takes about 3 to 6 hours with a 500 watts solar input. As you can see, these are two great power stations. Now it's time to tackle the Liberty engine. We are going to install the three electric generators. Ecoflow and Pecron with their solar panels, and we are going to have them charging during all the testing. Now we have the three engines ready. We start the Liberty engine. And if you want to see how it works, click on the link above. We are going to connect some devices to each engine and leave them for a few hours to see which one holds up better. The Liberty is generating its 220 volts as usual. The Pecron and Ecoflow are powering the devices while charging with the solar panels. We'll see what happens in a while. Three hours later, all the devices are still on. We are surprised that both batteries are still quite charged, because the solar charging is really efficient. They would have lasted many, many more hours. That's impressive. But the Liberty engine would have continued indefinitely. We are going now to try to overcharge the three motors to see how they respond. We will start with the Pecron. We are going to connect devices up to 2300 watts of power, and when using the grinders, the overload lock of the internal converter jams and it stops. It doesn't support more than 2000 watts. Let's repeat the test now with the Ecoflow. We connect all the devices again and activate them all at the same time. As you can see, this time the unit supports more power. The X-Boost allows surges up to 2400 watts without stalling. And in this case, all these devices have a peak of 2300 watts. Ecoflow has more capacity to withstand surges without problems. Now we will test our Liberty engine. We will now connect the same devices plus two fans with a total of 2600 watts. As we already knew, Liberty engine generates up to about 10,000 watts, so we could connect many more devices and it would still work. Although both commercial engines are very efficient, the Liberty engine is still the best option for the future. We leave you now with the pros and cons of the three motors. If you are looking for an external battery in anticipation of the coming energy shortage, you have the links of the two motors in the description. Ecoflow has surprised us with its ability to withstand overloads of up to 2400 watts. It has a very fast charge and it's very light and handy, although it has the lowest capacity of the three and its panel cannot be tilted, but it is a great motor. The Pecron has a battery with more capacity, although it doesn't withstand overloads of more than 2000 watts. Its panel can be put vertically and it has things like the dust cover or wireless charging that we really liked. And our Liberty engine, as you know, it has unlimited runtime. No need for fuel or extra batteries, it supports up to 10,000 watts of power, and the only bad thing is that, as we already told you, it's not commercially available. And it probably won't be until the company that has the patent considers it appropriate, because they can no longer exploit fossil fuels. Let's hope it will be soon.
Thanks for watching. We wanted to thank to all the members that subscribed recently. Thank for all of your support. Remember to become a member to access lots of exclusive advantages. Thank you.